Do you want to learn how to write SEO content 5 times faster without sacrificing quality? Well, ChatGPT can do just that and help you to write high-quality SEO content that will rank high on Google within mere minutes. The truth is that most people use ChatGPT in the wrong way for SEO. They play Russian roulette with Google by just copying and pasting AI content and hoping for the best. But Google's too smart for that. So if you want ChatGPT to help you to write SEO content that ranks, you need the right prompts, the right tweaks, and the right SEO strategy. By the end of this video, you're gonna know exactly how to use ChatGPT to write awesome SEO content that Google loves and that ranks high in the search engine. So get ready to save yourself a ton of time and let's go. Okay, so to use ChatGPT to help you to write awesome content, it all starts with the main keyword phrase that you're targeting. So let's imagine for a minute that I'm a lawn care service and I want to write a piece of content about mowing your lawn in the winter. So what most people do is they make the mistake of just going straight to ChatGPT and typing in that prompt. But don't do this because ChatGPT is going to give you a super AI type article that Google is going to be able to recognize and penalize you for. The truth is that ChatGPT is a great tool to make good content, but it shouldn't just be a replacement to make good content. It rarely works, and Google's smart enough to know the difference. So let me show you the right way to do this. First things first, you want to go to Google and you want to type in the main keyword phrase you are trying to write a piece of content about. So in this instance, we're going to say mowing your lawn in the winter, and we're going to do a quick search. So if this was my keyword, I care about what Google says is the top content on this subject matter. So if we take a look down here, you'll see that the first 4 results come up. So there's 2 big things that I can learn. Number 1 is, what is the content even about? And number 2, what intent is Google favoring? Is it a commercial intent or is it an informational intent for this keyword? Now, this keyword by nature is already an informational intent keyword, but sometimes Google will throw you for a loop and serve up commercial intent, which means that most of the people searching for this actually do want a commercial intent. So the first step is to take the top 4 results. So we want to open the content in a new tab. So I'm going to go ahead and do that for each of these. And what I'm really trying to accomplish by this is to get the URL so that I can feed these URLs into ChatGPT. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So over here in ChatGPT, we're actually going to feed it parameters. This is the big secret to AI, guys. The more you feed AI and tell it what to do with the information you've given it, you're going to get a way better result than just a random prompt of, hey, write me a piece of content about mowing your lawn in the winter. It's just not going to do a great job with that. But if I feed it parameters, it can actually do a really good job and give me a really good starting point that's 90% of the way there that I just need to make some small tweaks to and adjustments to be able to rank high on Google. So because ChatGPT now is connected to the internet, I can just tell ChatGPT that I want it to learn the information at a certain URL. So this is kind of how I would do this. I would say, learn the information from this URL. And I'm going to put a colon and I'm going to go to my first piece of content. I'm going to copy. On a PC, it's Control C to copy, or on a Mac, it's Command C. And then I'm going to go back to ChatGPT and I'm going to paste the URL. I'm going to hit enter. So what's really cool about this is ChatGPT is going to go to that URL and learn the information and store it to understand what it's about. Now I'm going to keep going. I'm going to say also learn the information at this URL. I'm going to take the second URL that we got, or the second result on Google. I'm going to copy the URL. I'm going to move back over to ChatGPT and paste this in. And I'm going to repeat this process for the next 2 URLs so that all 4 top results in Google have been fed in the ChatGPT. So I'm going to just do that quickly. Now, some of you might be asking, well, why aren't you just doing all 4 at once? Well, sometimes that can be really confusing to ChatGPT, and I would just want to give it a really clear input so that it doesn't mess it up. So I recommend doing it 1 URL at a time. So I'm going to grab our very last URL. I'm going to put it into ChatGPT and tell it to learn it. So now I have essentially fed ChatGPT with 4 URLs that have information about the topic that I want to write about. So now that ChatGPT has learned this information, this is kind of where the magic comes in and the trick of how to get better output from ChatGPT works. So now I would literally type in something like, with the information you have learned, write me a new article about mowing your lawn in the winter. Okay, so I'm going to hit enter, and now it's using the fed parameters that I gave it to write a piece of content that matches what Google is already ranking as the best content for this subject. The other really nice thing about feeding it parameters is it's using those statistics, that information from the information that I gave it, and you'll find that your hallucinations or ChatGPT making up stuff that isn't real, those instances go way down when you feed ChatGPT information like this. So ChatGPT has now just finished creating this piece of content. Now, I understand the urge right here to just copy and paste this into your website and call it good, but you can't stop. There's a couple more steps that you need to do. Step number one is we need to take a look at this piece of content, see how it reads, see if there's any repetition, and see what we could add to be able to give additional value to this piece of content. So there's two ways you could do this. You could ask ChatGPT to open this in Canvas, which is their version of a word processor. And when you do this, ChatGPT gives you this whole new view to be able to polish, you know, different things inside of the article, change it line by line, similar like how you would do it inside of a Google Sheet or a Google Doc or Word. The other thing that you could do is you could literally copy all this content, put it into a Google Doc and do your editing that way, or even into WordPress and do your editing right in there. So now that I have this Canvas view open, I have kind of two options. I could use AI to help me change things, you know, sentence by sentence. You know, I could tell AI to rewrite that sentence or swap out those words. I've found that sometimes that just takes more time than just going in and making the changes, right? Like in here, I can just click delete and we can change words or whatever we want. Or if I don't like this whole part of this, I can just highlight it and I could ask ChatGPT to say it in a different tone or to include a certain amount of information. So whatever is easier for you, I would recommend. But the point is, go through it, put your two cents on it. That is important because we want to be able to provide value to the user. That's what Google cares about. So now that you've made your changes on this piece of content to add your two cents and to give it some more value, next most important part is putting the keywords in this content in the right places. Putting your keywords inside the content the right way is super important to be able to rank high on Google and to do it quickly. And there's actually an entire science and method behind this that we've gone ahead and created a video that shows you step by step how to insert keywords in your content the right way. So make sure that you watch this video to ensure that your content has the keywords in there correctly so that it will perform. So click this link and we'll see you over there.